Hello students, today we will discuss this experiment to determine the friction coefficient for pipe of different diameter. For this, we are having apparatus by the name of pipe friction apparatus specially designed for this experiment, a measuring tape and a stopwatch. Now, if you see this diagram is for our apparatus. In this apparatus, we will be having different GI pipes which are attached to a common header which is getting supplied from a pump that is attached to it through a flexible pipe. On each GI pipe, there are two pressure tappings and the distance between these two tappings is fixed. It is around 2 meter and these two tappings, they are attached to a U-tube manometer to measure the pressure difference between the two tappings, is used to find out the head loss that has taken place between two tappings. Now, there is also a collection tank which is used to measure the flow rate, which is similar to what we have seen in other experiments also. Now, I will take you the setup and explain all these points there again, and then we will come back to this observation table and do one calculation to find out the friction coefficient for the pipe that we are using. Students, this is our pipe friction apparatus. You can see there are different dia pipes. So you can see there is, this is pipe is of 15 mm, this is 20 mm pipe, this is 25 mm pipe and this is 32 mm pipe. They are only attached to this header which is getting supplied from this centrifugal pump. There is a manometer, okay, you can see there is a manometer attached and this manometer is having attached to the pressure tappings. There are two tappings on each pipe. You can see this is tapping 1 and this is tapping 2. Distance between these two tapping is 200 centimeter or 2 meter. Now, these tappings, they are attached to this mercury U-tube manometer. Now, you can see here also, there is a measuring tank also available in this setup for measurement of the flow. You can measure the flow rate that is taking place through these pipes with the help of this attachment. Now, I will switch on my apparatus and I will take one reading and show you how to take the readings of flow measurement and your pressure measurement. Students, now you can see I have switched on my apparatus and you can see the water is flowing through this first pipe, that is 50 mm pipe, you can see, and other all pipes are closed. Now the water is flowing only through the first pipe. Now water is flowing through, you can see this, we can use here this tank to measure the flow rate. I am just maintaining the first level, okay, I am just maintaining initial level. You can see the liquid is rising up here in this tank and I have maintained the first level, which is 4 centimeters. Now I will take the stopwatch and start transferring my liquid. And note down how much amount of water I have accumulated in 10 seconds. Now you can see the level has risen to 8.5. So final level is 8.5 and the initial level is 4. You may note down this when we go back to the observation table, we will do the calculation regarding it. And for measuring the pressure, you can come on this side. We are having manometer setup for this. Now I am, as you can see, initially both the links, okay, the mercury link in both the manometers, they are at same level. Now
when I switch on my walls, you can see the pressure difference has come. Okay, you can see the pressure has dropped in this limb, and the pressure is less in this limb and more in this limb. So that's why this limb has gone down and this has come up. You should note down what is the level here. So this level is 23 and this level is 4.2. So you may note down this also. This is 23 and this is 4.2. Now we are moving back to our observation table. We will note down these values there and perform the required calculations for finding out the coefficient of friction, that is F.
Student, so this is our observation table. We have performed one reading corresponding to 50 mm pipe. So the dia of the GL pipe I have written is 50 mm, which is equal to 1.5 cm. Length of the pipe between the two pressure tapping, I have told you already, it is 200 cm. Area of the collection tank, it is 40 by 40. So it will come out to be 1600 cm square. Now, this you have noted and I have told you to note down the manometric readings. Left limb in centimeter, I have told you it is 23. And right limb, it is 4.2. Now, the difference in both head, it is 23 minus 4.2, which will come out to be 18.8. Now, this is in terms of mercury. If we want to calculate in terms of water, you will multiply by the difference of two densities, that is density of the mercury and the density of the water, which will be 12.6. So, if you multiply 18.8 by 12.6, you will get 236.88. Now, coming to the discharge measurements. Now, the initial level of the tank, I have told you it was 4 cm. Final level was 8.5 cm. And the area of the tank is 1600. Now, if you use this, and this is the amount of the volume that is coming in 10 seconds. If you divide that by 10, you will get the discharge, which will come out to be 720. Now, these are the calculations for your discharge and pressure difference. Now, in order to calculate our objective, that is friction coefficient, we will be using Darcy equation. You are familiar with this form. We have seen the derivation of this also in our theory class. HF is equal to FL V square upon 2GD. Now, if you convert this in terms of flow rate, here it is in terms of velocity. If you convert this formula in terms of flow rate, it will be 8FL Q square upon pi square GD raised to power 5. Now, from here you can calculate the friction coefficient and you can convert the friction coefficient and you will get this form. F will be equal to pi square g d raised to power 5 hf whole divided by 8 l q square. Now you can see, you know the value of g, you know the value of d, d is 1.5. You know the value of HF, pressure difference in terms of water, which we have calculated is 236.88 divided by, whole divided by 8L. L is 200, Q you have calculated 720. If you substitute these values, you will get the value of F to be 0.029. Now this is corresponding to one pipe. Similarly, you can do the number of readings. You can repeat the procedure for different pipes also and can find out the friction coefficient for different pipes by similar process. Thank you.